In this vlog, we will try to see how to design a simple website in Flutter. So now we have added an asset. So we have added a logo that needs to be displayed in our website here, and specify the same in pubspec file here. So under the assets, I have specified the logo, and now let's start with our coding. So let's import material dot dart file, void main. So inside I'm considering our default class my app, and now let us declare the class my app. So yes, now let's try to return a material app. Inside the home, we will be declaring a scaffold. So this particular scaffold will provide the structure for our project. And here you can see these are all the properties which we can make use of using a scaffold here. So as we are designing website, we are not making use of the app bar which we use for our mobile application. So directly we are going to declare the body over here. And inside the body, I'm just considering a stack. With the help of a stack widget, we can easily arrange our components inside our website one over the another. We have seen rows and columns previously, so this is a kind of a widget where we can align our layouts. For example, we want to display a text on my particular image. So in this particular scenario, we can make use of a stack and make it possible. So in this website, let us try to use the stack layout here and see how it's gonna look in. And inside the stack, we need to declare the children here, and there I just want to have a single child scroll view here. As we are dealing with a website, scroll view is a basic component here. So compared to our mobile application, web page will have more data, so we need to have a scroll view to handle this particular data. So now inside the scroll view, we are going to take a container, and this particular container we will be having some margin. So symmetric I am considering here, so symmetric and with a margin of 32 over here. So inside this container we will be further having some child here, and it will be contain a column, so that we will be adding multiple widgets. So inside the column, the first children we contain is again a container. This particular container will have a margin of symmetric again, and this time we'll be having 32 on vertical. So inside this container we will be having one more child, and this time it will be having row here. So inside the row, add the children, and here you need to specify the widget gesture detector, and inside which specify the on tap. Currently we are not making any process when you tap on this particular widget here. And also I am trying to add a child tag here, and inside which I am going to specify an image that is coming from asset. And in the starting of the tutorial we have added an image, right? So I'm going to specify that particular image now. So assets.logo.png, make sure you provide the name completely and with the specified format of the image. We need to have one more child inside this particular row, and that is flexible. Why we have made use of gesture detector and flexible here? With the help of a gesture detector, we are trying to show a logo onto our website. Just like in our homepage, we will be showing our website logo, and when the user taps on that particular logo, we will be redirecting to our homepage. So on whatever the page the user may be, like profile, about, or whatever the page it may be, we will be redirecting back to our home page, right? So it's a basic functionality. So for making sure that functionality is available in our Flutter website, we are adding a gesture detector, and also we have added a flexible here to make sure we display the menu on our website. So inside the flexible, I'm going to consider a container, and inside which I'm going to declare a child wrap. So with the help of a wrap, we can easily place our menu items one after the another by providing the sufficient space in between them. So inside the wrap, we need to provide a list of widgets we need to be displayed. So here I am going to specify a text button, and here I am going to leave the onPress functionality for now. And inside the child, I am going to specify a text widget which will be showing home. And in the same way, I'm going to add few more pages to our website here. So home, about, profile, contact, help, and like this you can add as many pages as you want here. So with the help of the flexible, it will be easier for us to place the menu items on our website. Inside the flexible, you are having an option to provide the flex property here. So here, if you specify it based upon the weights you provide, the widgets will be arranged in the proper constraints. In the Android programming, we are having a concept called weights. So with the help of the weights, we can provide the space covered by that particular widget onto the screen. So the same way, using the flex, we can provide the weights to our particular widgets in Flutter programming too. So here we are having only one flexible property here. So we will be dealing with the flexible in our further coming tutorials, and I will be showing you with a real-time example. Till now, let us try to run the particular code and see what is the output. Here you go, this is our output for the website which we have designed currently, and now the image size is too big, and let us try to limit its size here. So these are all the properties available, and inside I'm going to specify width here. So whenever you are having any doubts regarding the available properties inside the widget, you can just tap on this particular widget with the help of the command button in Mac and control button in Windows. So here I want to specify the width to be 50. So here now let us try to save. So home, about, profile, contact us, help, and now we want to have them to the right hand side. So inside our container, make use of the alignment property and specify alignment dot center of right here. So now let us try to see the output once. So you can still see the code is running on back, performing hot restart. So yes, our menu items are to the right hand side now. And also let us remove the debug banner, specify it to be false. Yes, we are not able to see the debug banner now. And here we will be trying to add some data to our website. So now let's try to close this particular container. I want to display an image with the help of a network here. So I want to load an image from a URL. So I am trying to add an image from Unsplash here. So this is the particular image I want to load to our website. Try to save the code, and here you can see our image is now loaded. And also you can add the image to your local assets folder here, and you need to specify the same in a pub spec here. So but I just want to add it from the network because we have added an image from local folder already. So I just want to show you from network now. We need to add a footer to our website also. So it might be a mobile application or a website. Header and footer are the important aspects of a page here. So in the same way, we are going to add a container, and inside the container, so here we will be adding a text widget, and inside which I am going to specify a website name. You can just add your own customizations here, and I want to wrap it with a widget align, and which will align my text to the center, bottom center. I will be specifying it. So now try to refresh our web page and check the output. So here you can see we have got our name printed just after the image, and now we want to have some space in between the image and our footer. So try to provide a margin, some margin here, and this time I want to have vertical of 50 here. Try to see the output. Yeah, it looks much better now. So this is how we create a basic website in our Flutter, and in our further coming tutorials we will try to customize this website with Google fonts, and also we will be styling our footer and header. And finally, to add web support to your project, you need to run a command flutter create, and you can notice in our code that we don't have a web directory. After adding the web support, you will be able to see the web directory in your code. And now to release the build for web, you need to run this particular command flutter build web. So here you can see the status compiling main.dart for the web, and here you can see our web directory is being created now, and also you can see other folders like Mac OS, Linux and Windows 2. Inside the web directory you can see the things like favicon. So in our further coming tutorials we will be trying to replace this particular favicon so that in the output you can have your own logo. And in our further coming tutorials we will be also going through these particular files, index.html, manifest and more. So yes, this is it for this tutorial on creating a simple website using Flutter. And if you are having any queries in this particular tutorial, do let me know in the comment section below. And the detailed code for this tutorial is available in the description section below. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.